Well, hello everyone! Blue Octopede here, and this is a video that has been in the works for many, many months. So, I'm sure some of y'all saw my community page, a teaser for a real prototype toy, and this is him right here. Before I get too deep into the video, though, I just want to talk about the curse real quick, because the reason this video has taken so long is because for whatever reason, I've had audio issues, like literally every single time I have tried to record this. So, I don't know. We'll see what happens with this particular recording, but the first time I had the video literally finished. I had the script done, I had everything filmed, it was great and wonderful, and then I went to export and checked the audio, and the audio got corrupted. So I literally had this entire video that I spent days putting together, and I was gonna have to completely redo the audio. So what did I do? I completely redid the audio. Plug the new audio in, and it sounds like garbage, like I'm in a trash can underwater. And I was like, okay, so that's not going to work. So I scrapped everything, and I refilmed the entire video a third time. And guess what? I went to play back the audio, and there was like a weird clicking sound throughout the entire recording. So, yeah, trying to make this video, something's just cursed with the audio, y'all. I don't understand it. I don't know what's happening, but whatever. This is going to be my last and final attempt, and regardless of what the audio sounds like, I apologize in advance if it's terrible, but this is it. And if it's bad, it's bad. I'm very sorry. But anyway, yeah, with that out of the way, on to the video. So, there was this toy line. Some of y'all may have heard of it, some of y'all may have not heard of it. It's called Big Rig Buddies. And it started off, y'all might have seen Rocky the Dump Truck. Basically, the first two toys were Rocky and Stinky the Garbage Truck. And I'm sure most of y'all will be more familiar with Stinky than Rocky. But basically, interactive toys, interactive trucks that, like, they stand up, they move around, yeah, see, like, and I'm trying to record now, and of course, there's going to be a thunderstorm, so there's probably going to be thunder and lightning all throughout this video. Great. Okay. Anyway, yeah, so the audio for this one's definitely going to be cursed, too. What was I talking about? Rocky and Stinky. So, yeah, they would stand up, and, like, the front two wheels were arms, and they would, like, waggle them around. It was really, really, really cute. Y'all go, look them up if you feel so inclined. But there were a lot of toys in the Big Rig Buddies kind of, like, line that came out after the main two. And these guys right here are part of the Real Talking line. So they're basically, I believe it's 1/8 scale, correct me if I'm wrong, but they don't have as much of the interactive features, but they do stand up and they do talk, and it's very, very, very cute. Now, the reason, let me move this little guy out of the way, the reason there are two of these is because this guy on the left here is the prototype of the truck on the right. And he's very, very fragile, which is why I'm wearing cloth jeweler's gloves and they're on a towel. He is made of resin, solid resin, and completely hand-painted. So he's, you know, he feels very, very heavy, but resin is really fragile. And this guy is probably 12 to 15 years old by now. I don't have an exact date on when he was made, but He's pretty old, pretty fragile, and he's already kind of beat up, but yeah, that's why I'm taking, like, extra precautions just to make sure he is, you know, that he stays in this condition. It's not perfect condition, I'd say, you know. B grade, C or B, because he's got some chips out of him and stuff. But yeah, he's not perfect, but he does work. And before I give a little audio visual demonstration, let me just go over the differences between this guy, the prototype, and the retail model. This guy's name is Swisher the Street Sweeper, by the way, or at least the retail version is. Something fun about prototypes is you learn things about the development of the retail toy through messing around with prototypes, and the prototype is actually not named Swisher. Put that on hold for just a second. Once I get into the audio clips, it'll make more sense. But let me just go over the differences between the two guys visually. So to start off, like I said, the prototype is made out of resin. So there's going to be a lot more fine detail than on the retail plastic model. For starters, let me just lift them both up so y'all can see the top. And yes, the prototype is pretty dusty, but like I said, he is hand-painted, which makes him a bit harder to clean because I don't want to rub the paint off. But looking at them from the top, there's the detail is just much crisper, much cleaner. Even looking at them from the sides, the grill and everything is just, I don't know. It's a lot finer and a lot more cleanly detailed. The main difference, though, is the scrub brush. So this guy is a street sweeper, and he actually doesn't look like your standard street sweeper. Normally, these things, if y'all have ever seen one out in the wild, it's like a little square boxy truck. Usually they only have like one or two seats in them that I've noticed. And underneath where the wheels are, there's two scrub brushes. And what the scrub brushes do is when the car is like driving around, they push the dirt and debris and stuff up toward a vacuum that's up underneath on the belly of the truck. And that just kind of sucks the debris up. So pretty cool. These guys are different though. He's got two kind of little arm looking things holding a giant scrub brush on his front. And the prototype doesn't roll very well, so I'll show y'all on the retail toy. As he's rolling forward and backward, that big kind of cylindrical scrub brush is what's going to push the dirt up underneath him. So kind of a different design, and I'll go into the lore of that later. This video is probably going to be split into parts, so if I don't cover that on this video, it'll definitely be in a later one. But anyway, the difference is in the scrub brush. So the prototype, the cylinder, whoa, buddy, don't roll off my hand, please. The cylinder is actually made of paper. It's either a thick paper stock or cardboard. It's definitely not plastic. And he's got these kind of like hard plastic, I don't know, they're bendy, almost like they're metal. But they're kind of clear orange, very, very strange. But they're very hard, bristly brushes, whereas on the retail toy, it's just rubber. Everything is rubber. The cylinder's rubber, the bristles are rubber, and it's very, very satisfying to, like, run your fingers over it. And fun fact about the prototype, they actually thought that he was the prototype of the little die-cast figure. And, I mean, obviously, looking at them side by side, he's about, I don't know, four times bigger than the die-cast version. But fun fact, this guy is actually pictured in an official, like, Matchbox marketing thing with the die-cast toys. So they used him as a photo prototype for the little die-cast toy, and I assume that was all the seller had to go off of because that's genuinely what they thought he was. But he's actually part of the Real Talking toy line. So, fun fact, I'll go ahead and throw that image up there so y'all can see. And anyway, going back to comparison, let's see, turn him on his side here. The wheels are basically the same. The red button on top, which is what makes him pop up and say his phrases, is basically the same. The paint is a little bit shinier. I mean, just because it's hand painted and is not, you know, mass produced quality, you know, whatever kind of paint you'd call that. And let's see. He's got a sticker on his side that says 8 Team, which is, I don't know, the colors are a little bit different. And throughout, he's got, you know, little blue and white stripey stickers that are not quite in the same places. Some of them are a little bit different. On the retail toy, there's one sticker that's a bit further down, but other than that, they're basically the same. The stickers are a little bit different on the sides of the arms. On the retail toy, it kind of, I don't know, wings out on the sides to make it, like, fit better within the molded plastic of the arm. And you can see right here where the paint has chipped off, and you can see some of the resin underneath on the prototype's arm. There's also a concerning crack going through right there. So, again, you know, I'm just being super, super careful. There's another, crack in the resin right there, so y'all can see what that looks like. Oh yeah, the speaker grill is different. On the prototype, it's just like some lines, I don't know, just like straight, you know, kind of a rectangle of lines going down. And on the retail toy, it's a lot bigger, and you can definitely tell a sound quality difference with, you know, more holes for the sound from the speaker to come through on the side there. Another big difference is, actually, let me show y'all the retail first. So underneath, do I have him right side up? Nope. It's this way. So underneath here, there's the Matchbox logo. He's dated 2010 by Mattel. There's a little product ID number right there. And on his belly, where he's actually attached into the packaging, there's little holes where, it's probably zip ties or something. I'm really not sure. These guys are incredibly hard to find. It took me a long time to find this Swisher. He was actually in a lot with a Real Talking Stinky, and that's like the only one I've seen for sale for an entire year. I guess he just didn't, I don't know. I guess the Real Talking line either didn't sell well, or I don't know, they just didn't make a lot of them for whatever reason. It's a theme with this guy that there's a lot of mystery, and again, I'll go into that later. But going back to his underside, there's a lot of, like, you know, your standard, this device complies with Part 15 of FCC rules of operation, blah blah blah, just because he's an electronic toy. There's a little, like, recycling, or no recycling thing, little screwdriver icon, so yeah, just your basic electronic toy warnings and stuff underneath there. And on the prototype, you'll notice that he is surprisingly blank underneath. There's no Mattel branding, no date, no marketing information, no battery, you know, information or whatever. And the only reason I even knew that he took 3 button cell batteries was because he came with 3 button cell batteries, and they were clearly the same ones that had been in him since he was made, because they were quite crusty and disgusting. But again, you can see, you know, some nice detailing where he was hand-painted. Unfortunately, a lot of the paint has rubbed off of his wheels from being rolled around. I'm not sure what this guy was used for other than the photo in the one catalog, and I mean, since he has working electronics, I'm going to assume he was used for possibly a commercial, maybe? I haven't found a commercial of him yet, but either that or just to display, you know, here's how the toy works and here are the sound bites he has. I've tried to get in touch with so many people about this prototype, and there's nothing. No one wants to talk to me. I even got in touch with Jeff Ray Kemper, the guy who made Rocky, and he had nothing for me. At least he actually spoke to me, but nothing. May as well have not have been a conversation at all. Sorry, Jeff, if you see this, but you were not helpful. You were not helpful at all. At least a secretary was nice, though. But, yeah, that's basically it for, like, a physical overview of the toy. He's got the scrub brush on front, nice cute little blue truck cab with the white, like, tank where the trash would go, you know, if he were a real vehicle. Now, the fun part, though, is his electronics. And I did completely open him up to take a look at his insides, and I'll throw an image on screen that I took. So everything about the prototype is, as far as I can tell, handmade. All the electronics are definitely handmade, and they're definitely kind of sketchy looking. But if he is just to test, you know, or if he's just to show off, rather, the basic, like, functionality of the toy, they did a great job. Let me actually put the diecast toy over here, just for comparison. So the diecast toy, you just kind of, you pull him up and he stands up and there's his little scruff brush, you know, pretty, very cute, very cute. And these guys, the real talking toys, see this big red button on the top here? You press that and he pops up and he says a phrase. And let me actually, well, he says a bunch of phrases. So let me kind of angle my camera up. And all right, here's the retail toy. Spotless. And you'll see when he pops up, he says the phrase and his eyes or headlights blink in time with the words. So let me just... Hi, I'm Swisher, the street sweeper. Thanks, buddy. And I'm going to pop him down now. Let me do the same on the prototype.
I'm always in a brush.
So right away you'll notice his voice is a little bit deeper, isn't it? Let me raise him up again.
Got clean, sir. Got clean.
Now with the prototype, the headlights do light up, but they're not in sync with what he's saying yet. So they'll just kind of blink, you know, at a set interval. But y'all, I am so thrilled that this prototype works, and he works perfectly too. There was one spring that was loose inside when I first got him and opened him up. I did glue that back in so he springs up like he's supposed to. Now real quick, let me just cycle through the prototype's sound clips until I find the one that I'm looking for, and you'll know it when you hear it.
Hi, I'm Scruffy. I never miss a spot.
So, remember what I said before about the prototype not being Swisher? The prototype has the name Scruffy, and I about lost my mind when I was going through and recording all of his sound clips and heard the name Scruffy. So, this guy definitely is basically a complete toy at this point. And like I said, I've tried to get in touch with so many people. The person I bought him from would not tell me anything. I've tried to get in touch with various voice actors. So far, no one has gotten back to me. Real quick, just inserting this into the first part of the Real Talking Swisher prototype video. I actually got a tweet back from Wally Wingert, the voice actor who did the voices of Roger and Dexie for Big Rig Buddies. I was not expecting to get replies back from anyone, and he was the first to show up, so thank you so much, Wally. Hopefully he can either confirm or deny that he was the voice of Swisher, so just wanted to let y'all know. I'll go ahead and throw this in the middle of my editing, so yay! And yeah, there's no information that I can find on this guy. And I think what I'll do in the next video is kind of go more into the lore. Lots of theories that I have about Scruffy. And let y'all hear all the different sound bites. Because there are some different ones. They definitely went back and re-recorded almost all of the lines for the retail toy. But some of them are the same. And like I said, you know, I'll let y'all hear all of them. It's very, very fascinating to me anyway. Because this guy, I'm going to have to guess that he was finished maybe 2008 or at the earliest, probably 2009, because he does show up in the 2010 catalog, and the retail Swisher the Street Sweeper is marked 2010 also, like y'all saw earlier. So I wish I had more information on this guy, but really, like I said, I'm just gonna have to throw out some theories, but I don't know. I'll go into that in the next video. So I guess I'll just end this here. Go ahead and upload this and get started on the next video. So I will see y'all pretty shortly. Bye.